In our last few videos, we got to taste, evaluate, and discuss white wines and rosé wines. If you missed those videos and would like to view them, please click the links below. In this video, we're going to start our discussion of red wines. And we're going to get to taste Pinot Noir and Syrah, made from two red noble grapes. A little bit about red wines. The most obvious thing about red wines is its color. Red wine gets its color from the grape skins. During maceration and fermentation, the juice and the skins are in constant contact with one another, and that's where the color comes from. Red wine color ranges from light red to deep dark purple or almost black color. As red wine ages, it loses color and will change to a brownish red brick color. Red wine likes to be served from 50 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit. I know that's a wide range, but the specific temperature for any specific wine is dictated by the grape varietal from which that wine is made. Most red wines like to be decanted. The length of decanting also is dictated by the grape varietal from which the wine is made. Red wine likes to be served in red wine glasses, of which there are two types, the Bordeaux glass and the Burgundian glass. The Bordeaux glass is designed to direct and deliver aromas to the nose. It also provides a large surface area for that ethanol gas to escape, and it's designed to soften the wine for drinking. Examples of wines for the Bordeaux glass are Cabernet Sauvignon and Merlot. The Burgundian glass is a broader, rounder bowl for lighter, light-bodied red wines with more subtle aromas. It's that round, broad bowl that collects those subtle aromas. Examples of wines for the Burgundian glass are Pinot Noir and Gamay. We're going to be tasting Pinot Noir first. The Pinot Noir I'm going to be tasting is from the Willamette Valley in Oregon. A few things about Pinot Noir. A Pinot Noir grape is a dark-skinned grape. It grows in Europe, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, South America, Canada, and the United States. The best Pinot Noirs outside of the United States come from the Burgundy region of France, where the most prestigious and most expensive Pinot Noirs are made. In the United States, Pinot Noirs are grown in California, Oregon, Washington, New Mexico, Texas, Idaho, Michigan, Virginia, and New York. The best Pinot Noirs in the United States come from California, Oregon, with Washington a very close third. Those three states have some distinct characteristics of their climate which make them great for Pinot Noir, and that is a long growing season, a dry, warm summer, and a mild but somewhat wet winter. Now, evaluate our Pinot Noir. Clarity, brilliance, very nice. Legs are there, but they're somewhat slight, but they're, you can see them. Probably a light body Pinot Noir. The color of this particular Pinot Noir, I would say, is somewhere between a light and medium red. Let's get ready to sniff our wine by swirling our wine and take that first sniff. A very distinctive barnyard aroma, and I'm sure you know what I mean by barnyard, what lays around in a barnyard. Now let's try that second sniff, see what else we can pick up. Blueberries, blackberries, mint, spices, very nice. Let's try a taste. The red berries, raspberries, cherries, strawberries, coffee, black tea, chocolate, very nice Pinot Noir. Body, like I said, I figured somewhere between light and medium, but probably in the middle. Alcohol, again, I think it's going to be middle range for a Pinot Noir. It's not too much, but it's plenty warm enough. Acidity, somewhere between medium and high. Not really too high, it's right on. Sweetness, it's absolutely dry. And tannins are definitely low. This is a really nicely balanced wine. All the elements are right where they need to be, but also in that real nice sweet spot. So this is a really nice Pinot Noir. Food pairings for this particular Pinot Noir: chicken, turkey, game, birds like pheasants, and chocolate. Let's compare this to a typical Pinot Noir. A typical Pinot Noir is between a light red and a medium red, so that's right on there. Aromas, the signature aroma of Pinot Noir is that barnyard aroma, along with those blackberries and blueberries, the spices and the mint. Flavors run the gamut. All those red berries, chocolate, coffee, black tea, spices. So far so good. Body, light to medium, we're good there. Alcohol, 12 to 15%. This particular Pinot Noir is 13.8. So it is like mid-range. Acidity, medium to high. Again, we're right on. Sweetness, the majority of Pinot Noirs and the best Pinot Noirs are made dry. Tannins are low to medium, so we're right there. This has all the characteristics of a typical Pinot Noir, but I think this is much better than a typical Pinot Noir. This is a very nice Pinot Noir. Additional things about Pinot Noir. Pinot Noir likes to be served from 55 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit. It likes to be served in that Burgundian glass if you have one. If not, any red wine glass like a Bordeaux glass will do. Decant Pinot Noir up to 30 minutes. Pinot Noirs were aged up to 15 years. Food pairings for Pinot Noirs: chicken, turkey, game birds, lamb, rabbit, duck, chocolate, and cheese like brie. I would tell you one thing. If I am going to choose a red wine for Thanksgiving, Pinot Noir pairs with turkey in an unbelievable way. It really makes your Thanksgiving. I also use Pinot Noir as my introductory red wine to new red wine drinkers because of its smooth, soft tannins. Well, we've completed our Pinot Noir assessment. I'm going to take a small piece of white bread to cleanse my palate, and then we'll taste and evaluate our Syrah. Well, a couple things about Syrah first. It's also a dark-skinned grape, which is native to France. It's grown in Europe, Asia, Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, South America, and the United States. The best Syrahs outside of the United States are grown and produced in the northern Rhone Valley in France and in Australia. In Australia, Shiraz is the name for Syrah. I can't tell you why the Australians changed the name to Shiraz, and there seems to be no documented reason for it. In the United States, Syrah is grown in California, Oregon, Washington, New Mexico, Texas, Colorado, Idaho, and Hawaii. That might be a surprise. Wine grapes and wine are produced in Hawaii. The best rated Syrahs in the United States come from California and Washington. The Syrah I'm going to be drinking is from Walla Walla, Washington. Well, let's taste our Syrah. First, the clarity, the brilliance, very, very nice. The legs, well, this has some legs. I'm going to say we're probably looking at something like a medium bodied Syrah. Color. This is a deeper, darker red than that Pinot Noir. More towards that purple cast, but deep, dark red. That swirler wine, and get ready to focus on aromas. Again, a very distinctive first aroma. Raw meat, gamey type of aroma. Let's try from some secondary aromas. Oh, the blackberries for sure. Black currant, blackberries, blueberries. Let's try a taste. A wide range of taste. Licorice, chocolate, plum, mint, some spices. Very nice wine. Body, I think, is somewhere in that medium range. Maybe a little more than medium, but medium at least. Alcohol, again, it's not too warm, it's warm. I'm gonna think it's in the middle range for Syrahs. Acidity, medium. Sweetness, again, absolutely dry. Tannins, somewhere between medium and high, but in a real nice spot. Overall balance, I think this is another really well-balanced wine. The tannins aren't too high, the alcohol's right there, the acidity's right where it needs to be, and the body is probably a little more than medium, and I think it all works well together. I think this is a really well-balanced wine. Food pairings for this particular Syrah: barbecue meat, steak, lamb, rabbit, game meats like elk and venison. Well, let's compare this to a typical Syrah. Syrah in color is this deep, dark red or almost purple color, so we're good there. Aromas. The number one aroma for Syrah is that raw meat aroma, along with the blackberries. Blackberries, black currants, blueberries, plums, and some spices. Flavors, they run the gamut as well. Licorice, chocolate, plums, another plum-like fruit, the damson, mint. As far as body goes, Syrahs tend to be medium to high, so we're good there. Alcohol, 13 to 17%. This is 14.5, so it is kind of the middle of the range. Acidity, most Syrahs are mediums, but they can be high, so between medium and high, but most are medium. Sweetness, most and best Syrahs are dry. Tannins tend to be from medium to high, so we're good there as well. This has all the typical characteristics of a Syrah, but again, very much like our Pinot Noir, I think this is a little bit more than just a typical Syrah. I think this is a pretty nice Syrah. Some other notes about Syrahs. Syrahs like to be served from 60 to 68 degrees Fahrenheit. They like to be served in a Bordeaux glass. They like to be decanted up to 60 minutes, and that's because of their usually high tannins. They can age up to 15 years, and food pairings. Again, those barbecue meats, steaks, game meats, elk, venison, game birds, pheasants, grouse, lamb, duck, goose, chocolate, and aged hard cheeses like cheddar and gouda. Well, we've completed our discussion of both the Syrah and Pinot Noir wines. I really enjoyed my wines. I hope you did too. In our next video, we'll be picking up the last two red wines, Cabernet Sauvignon and Merlot. I hope to see you then. And as always, raise a glass and have a drink.